All right, crunch time on the jump. Jonquel Jones put up 32, 18 boards in game two. She is the first player ever with at least 30 and 15 in a WNBA finals game. Only the third player to do it in a WNBA playoff game. So Nick, if Deladon is out, we just say, all right, the Sun are winning the title?
Yeah. If you put up 32 and 18 in a finals game, that's a wrap on all that.
Miss Jones is in the house.
That's right. That's right.
I am interested to see how this goes. There was a great segment, by the way. If you're watching the game last night, I got to shout out Holly Rowe because she did a great thing with both, I mean, got all of the Washington teams, the Mystics and the Wizards, in their community efforts. It was very cool. So shout out for her and them. Greg Popovich hasn't forgotten how Marcus Morris backed out of a deal with the Spurs this offseason. At Media Day, Pop said the Spurs were, quote, blindsided. This is relevant because the Spurs host the Knicks in their season opener. Scotty, do you think the Spurs will hold a grudge against Morris? And do you think he cares?
I feel like Pop is. I don't know what the players are. He didn't really get in with the players, but yeah. I think Pop is a little pissed.
The NBA is built on grudges.
Well, that's true.
Large and small. So, hell yeah, Pop's going to remember this. Deliver that message to his team.
There is a built-in period of when guys agree to deals and then sign deals. For a reason. I mean, there isn't, it's not, you can't sign them on the same day that you can start agreeing to them. So I guess that's part of the reason.
Aren't they trying to switch that?
I feel
like that was possible last year, Rach.
So much. Two big stories out of Bucks training camp. Giannis says he doesn't want to talk about a potential 2020 Supermax extension. Also, Giannis is working on his shooting with Kyle Korver. So which is the biggest story? He's not going to talk about whether he'll sign the Supermax or that Kyle's tutoring him.
The Supermax is always the story because he is the biggest domino there is in the league.
Right.
So no matter what, that is always going to take precedent.
Forget that Supermax. Focus on that jump shot.
See?
You're working with one of the greatest shooters in the game. Stay focused.
See, I agree. I think right now, him working with Korver is the bigger story, right? Him saying he's not going to talk to the media about this, fine. But get the shot going and everything will change. All right, at Suns Media Day, DeAndre Ayton said, quote, I'm definitely shooting the three this year. In September, Ayton also said power forward is his natural position. Now, last season, he took 4 3-point shots.
How'd he do on those, Rach?
He did not get any of them to go in the hoop.
Oh,
but look, you want people to add to their game. Is it smart for him to attempt more threes in his second season, Scotty?
Yes, it's smart. I mean, he only took 4. And, you know, you want to see some growth in a player from year in and year out. So I want to see him shoot some threes. But to be honest, don't forget who you are. Mm-hmm. Stick with what you know, the dunk.
Right.
You're a dominator down low.
Yeah,
he can be dominant down low. And this guy wants to start taking threes.
I don't think he said that he's going to never be near the rim again, but we've seen big guys.
But once you start, what guy, once he starts pulling away from the rim, is like, you know what? I need to go all the way back in. I feel like every big guy who starts taking threes, like, you know what? I like it more out here. I don't have to get drilled every time I go up for a rebound. It's better out here.
I think if you want to evolve in the league, as the league is evolving,
nice
you
got
to go with it. Yeah, I mean, you know, I don't know. I'm never going to get on a guy for trying to add to his game.
Don't try too hard.
He's young.
Don't listen to Scottie Pippen. Don't let it go at every other expense of the game that you've already built now.
I would say that there are a lot of things that Suns team can improve on. Sorry, our researcher, Michael Schwartz. And, you know, anybody who wants to do better on that team, we should applaud because they need it and the fans, they really need it. This is just in at the buzzer. Let's take a look at Zion Williamson. We're talking about practice today. Zion flushing down an alley-oop at Pelicans practice. It's from Lonzo Ball. It's off camera. But take a look. He just, woo, look at how he stays up there. Grabs the ball. It's like a good second before it goes through the hoop.
I can't wait for the season to start. I thought I'd never say this, but I can't wait to watch the Pelicans play.
Look at that.
You put that on every video they got.
I'm not kidding. I said this at the top of the show. This kid has already changed so much for the Pelicans, and they're sitting there being like, don't expect too much from him. He was saying yesterday, I'm not trying to dunk or do crazy things in practice. Already we're at day two. Here we go.
Actions always speak louder than words in the NBA. Mm-hmm. This is another example. You keep seeing this, you're going to get the hype machine flowing. I just can't wait for Zion versus Zach LaVine at the dunk contest in Chicago. Oh. That is going to be awesome.
Zion needs to be in the dunk contest. He has said, I don't think I'm doing it. I don't know. You need to come.
It's time.
It needs to happen. We're back tomorrow on
ESPN.
They'll be back with
Jordans.
Me. That's right. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.